So it has been a while since we gave information about what we are working on. So here we go. We're gonna put 1 inch and another 75 inch on those gaps. Sometimes there is like a leftover rivet. So I'm just gonna pass by with a chisel and remove them. After, I'm just gonna hoover and make sure there is no like leftover pieces on the bottom. I'm making a tryout to know what size you want in your gap, and then cut.
Empápate el cuerpo de hermosura y empieza ya a sentir la lozanía que toda una avalancha de ternura te envuelva entre sus manos finas. La profundización de la locura torciendo a ciencia exacta la medida produce sensaciones de
kind of pull the board away and you make it really tight for the foam to get in, especially on the corner. So Carlos start cutting the edge, like he got the idea. So now it's what I'm doing. I'm cutting the edge and then it's easier to slide it in.
Solid jungle glue.
I'm really stressed about it, but it have to be fine because we're gonna have to do it in one point and we can't procrastinate electricity. We are at this step where we need to think of our system with our outlet, with our light, with our appliances, with all the cable, the fuse, the breaker, the battery, and I probably forgot a lot of things, but I'm gonna give more detail later. So my goal for today is I'm gonna tape more or less our layout on the floor.
I don't know what to say, the monkey won't do. I don't know what to say, the monkey won't do. One Sunday morning I woke up late.
I start to plan the floor the way we put it on paper and we realized that we needed to do some changes for balancing the weight and for practicability. Ta-da! It's a mess! We have a doubt with our toilet slash bathroom. So we decided to mount what we have already because we have the shower base, we have the lavabo, and we have like a little piece of furniture that we would like to put as well above the toilet. We just want to move things around and, you know, put our head set with what we want, like that we can work on our lighting. So I'm trying to fix my backlights that are leaking. So we have this like foam, which is a bit old. And then I think what the problem is, these things over here. There is four screws that are basically tightening the light with the bus structure, which are basically those four screws, which represent those one. And those one here are the one who hold the light with the frame light. This is quite thin, so it's super squishy and is large enough to cover the holes. So when you disconnect everything, some of them have the ground attached to the back. So I'm just gonna unscrew the ground. Then you can cut the hot wire. So now I'm gonna work with that, getting rid of all the leftovers. So a little bit of a cleanup and the last setup.
Muy buenos días, queridos estudiantes. La clase de calle 13 básica va a comenzar. Por favor, no se confíen.
Pa' empezar adelante, tú a mí no te pareces, ni aunque hagas brujería, pillería o reces 100 veces, tú a mí no te pareces, solamente va a haber un solo residente, calle 13.
I am actually working with wood for a change. I am making the baseboards to hold the floor panels down on the bus that we put, because the sheets are like warped up and the glue doesn't work so well. This goes against the wall of the bus, and then we press it down. These hold it down, these hold it from sliding.
Superman, pero ahora ya quiero ser diputado del pano, del brillo, del PRD. O cualquier cosa que tenga un poco de poder. Quiero convertirme en el músico político y construirle un piso al periférico. Quiero acabar con el tráfico. Tengo que entrar en la historia de México. Y luego miro al pecero que va medio pedo, jugando carreras con los pasajeros. Pero hoy tiene que pasar primero. Sin luces, sin frenos, junto al patrullero. Aunque no sepa leer, no sepa hablar, él es el que te brinda la seguridad. Así lo tienes que respetar, porque él representa nuestra autoridad.
So you think you're gonna hit me, but now we're gonna hit you bad. So you think you're gonna hit me, but now we're gonna hit you bad. So you think you're gonna hit me, but now we're gonna hit you bad. So you think you're gonna hit me, hit me.
We are basically sort of overlapping it with the plywood, so that the middle of this is between two boards. And then I already pre-grilled holes. So there's three here that are gonna go against the metal. And then once it's set, then I have these here that are gonna drill into the wood only. First thing is liquid nail. So I go ahead and set the glue. Then I'll put it on the plywood here on the bottom, and then on the side of the actual baseboard. And this is sideways right now, so I'm putting it on this wall. I press up against the other baseboard that's already set, and then I lay it into the corner.
So the method I came up with was using, I call it the reverse turnbuckle technique, where you do with the turnbuckle what it wasn't designed to do, but it works here. You know, normally like these are to pull tension. I'm actually just sort of screwing out to push.
So right now I just get it snug, and then with the vice grip, I just hold it in place. Turnbuckles on the ends, and then one in the middle. And now I just give it a little nudges to keep it close to the wall. So my square, I put a yellow tape right at a little over 9.5 inches. When I start turning a turnbuckle and I get this to a position over in the yellow.
I think I'm pretty tight.
I like where I'm at, so now I do self-tapping screws into the metal plate. So now it's drilled to the side. I'm using a wood screw, wood to wood. And then we keep going.